morning, Trojans. Today is Monday, January 31st.
We hope you all had a fantastic weekend, and today is a special day. It's Claire's birthday.
Yay!
Happy birthday, Claire!
Anyways, last week, our boys and girls soccer team had their senior nights.
Take a look at what some of our seniors have to say about their time playing here at Ash.
I'm here with the three captains of the girls' soccer team. I've heard they've done really well this year. So what is one of y'all's favorite games from the season?
I think our best game from the season was when we played Captain Sharif, because even though we tied them, it was a good experience and we all worked really hard together.
You've all played multiple sports. What made soccer stand out to y'all?
Well, I'm currently a cheerleader and a track runner, but the reason why I love and chose soccer is because I just get a sense of energy and I feel a rush when I get on the field, and so it just strengthens my passion for soccer.
I also run track and cross country, and the whole reason why I went into soccer is because, unlike track and cross country, soccer has a different vibe to it and a different bond with teammates that I don't get from the other sports.
Since y'all are all seniors this year, what is one thing you're all gonna miss most about soccer?
I think the thing that I'm gonna miss the most about soccer is spending time with all the girls and making fun memories.
What I'm going to miss the most is how, like KK said, how the team is together, as well as how I am being pushed harder to become better at soccer.
Thanks, girls. Best of luck to them as they get ready for the playoffs.
Now we're going to talk to the senior captains on the boys' team.
There are 11 seniors this year, and most of them have been playing together for a young age.
It sounds like it was a bittersweet night for most of them. Let's take a look at what they have to say.
Hey, guys. I'm here with five of the senior boys on our soccer team. So I've heard you guys are having a really great season this year. Can you tell me about how playing together before you came to Ash helped you build your team?
Well, we've been playing together for many years, some of us 5, 6, even 8 years, and it's really helped us build a team chemistry and a friendship where we understand what type of players we are and what we're capable of to demand more from each other, and it's really helped us achieve what we really want to achieve this year.
So you guys have spent a lot of time playing on this field. Can you tell me about some of your favorite memories you've made?
Yeah, well, my favorite memory is probably when we knocked out Pineville in penalties in the playoffs my freshman year.
So what would you guys miss the most about being a part of the Ash soccer team?
Got to be these four boys. Been playing with them since pre-K, actually.
I'm definitely going to miss just crushing teams with my boys.
I'm going to have to agree with all of them. I'm going to miss all of them. And playing alongside them so many years is going to be heartbreaking to leave.
Okay, what is your ultimate goal for this season?
To win state for Kutztown! Let's go!
Another Trojan we want to highlight comes from the English department.
That's right. This week's teacher shout-out is Miss Loken.
Tune in to Jackson and Megan to tell us more.
This week's teacher shout-out goes out to Miss Loken.
Miss Loken has been teaching for 14 years, and this is her second year at Ash. Prior to coming here, she taught in schools in Texas and Missouri.
Miss Loken teaches English 1. Here's what her students have to say about her.
She's a hardworking teacher, and she always makes sure students are where they need to be.
She teaches very clearly and explains things very well.
She's so sweet, and she is a great teacher.
She is one of the most patient and compassionate people ever.
She always has a positive attitude.
Miss Ash is so lucky to have you, Miss Loken.
Thank you for all you do.
Thanks, guys. Miss Loken seems to be very appreciated here at Ash. Now, as you all may remember, we heard from a fan favorite last week, and he told a pretty hilarious joke.
That's right, and you're all in luck because Mr. Rudd is back to tell us his second part to his three-part joke.
Let's take a look.
The stakes are too high. He gets seated at the table, and he notices across the room an attractive woman sitting by herself. And he then notices another gentleman approach her at her table, and he could tell by the body language that the gentleman was asking if he could sit with her. And he could tell right away that she was not interested, and the man's shoulders slumped and he went back to his seat. And then he saw another gentleman approach this very attractive woman, and once again he was, that's a negative, okay? Once again, shoulders slumped, back to his seat. And he looked at her again, and he thought, well, maybe I'll give it a try, right? And before he could do that, she sneezed. and a glass eye popped out of her head and started to fly across the room. And he reached out with his hand and caught it. And he brought it over to her, and she said, "Well, thank you for catching that. Would you like to have dinner with me?" And she's very embarrassed. And he's like, "Sure, I'll have dinner with you." And as they finished up laughing and talking and talking about things that adults talk about, like 2K Civics, he said, "Well, how come you wanted to eat dinner with me as opposed to those other two gentlemen?" And she paused for a moment and said, "Well, you did catch my eye."
Oh my gosh, that was so funny, Mr. Rudd. We can't wait to hear the third part of your joke.
Yeah, I'll be counting down the days. Well, that's it for our show this week. We hope you have a great day, and go Trojans!